I'm Nicole King, and this is Marbella Now.
Hey, hey, it's a brand new day.
Joining me as my first guest is Georgina Shaw of Shaw Marketing Services. People who watch the show regularly will know her face, and I'm sure a lot of you will know her just because of the excellent work that she does. So professional, so organized, and always all over the place. So Georgina, welcome back.
Thank
really
you.
Nice to see you
what
again.
What a lovely introduction.
Well, you are. You're just so capable, and we all have our abilities. And I think, as you know, my hashtag better together is if we can put those together and complement each other, it just makes a great team. So,
absolutely does, absolutely does. We need to know our strengths and our weaknesses in able to ask the right questions for the right help when we need it.
Exactly. And one of the things that I get Georgina to help me with every year is our United Nationalities of Marbella Summit. Georgina is the MC, the master of ceremonies, and makes sure that no one oversteps their mark and doesn't talk for too long. But we'll be talking about this year's United Nationalities Summit in just a moment. First, let's just have a catch up in general. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you, Nicole. Very busy. I have to say that probably since November last year or December, we have been the busiest we've ever been. We've never had a busier summer. Lots of new clients coming in and asking for it right now. In the moment, let's go, let's go. I feel like there's a lot of positivity in the air. People feel it's kind of do or die. We've got to go now. And for me, from a marketing perspective, that's great. And I've been helping lots of different people in different respects, which is great fun and really
what
rewarding.
What kind of services do you cover?
Well, we are a full service marketing and communications agency. So you will know us from our PR side, which is media relations, press releases, and putting out information about events. But we also do a lot of social media at the moment, and a lot of copywriting. So we've been writing blogs for holiday homes in Ireland and rehab facilities and all kinds of weird and wonderful things, and rewriting websites and just generally helping people to promote themselves well and effectively online and offline.
People, I think, are becoming to realize the importance of not only having a representation, but that the quality of that representation being good. Mm-hmm. Too many people just like get people, friends to translate websites as opposed to getting it done professionally. Mm-hmm. And as you said, having good content is fundamental, even if you're just doing social media posts.
Yeah, it really is. And I think that, like you say, people sort of think, well, I can write an email, I can bang up a few social media posts. And some people can. And I often say to people, we can help you if you want to learn how to do it. If you're a good writer and you're confident in that sphere, give it a try. But if you are busy working on your business and you really want to appear professional, my advice would always be to hire a professional to help you. Then you can forget about that. You know it's being done well, and you can just do the important business of actually running your company.
Yes, obviously, if you overstretch, it's very difficult to do everything mm-hmm. to the same level. When people think about getting in a marketing company, a PR company, I think we instinctively think a lot of money.
Yes.
And that is scary. And that's why a lot of people suffer on their own. Mm-hmm. It isn't the case.
No.
I think people would be actually very pleasantly surprised if you just reach out and ask questions.
Yes, yeah. I mean, you know, every pound or euro that we spend on our business, we have to feel that we're going to get a return on. But I think you're right that people think there's going to be, you know, tens of thousands of euros. It absolutely is not that. And we pride ourselves on doing cost-effective work where we can sort of really drill down to where we think that the most bang for your buck will be. And we're very happy to work within people's budgets. And we prefer people to come look and say, look, Georgina, I really need your help. What can you do for this? And then we can try and work out the best strategy for them.
Obviously, knowing the local community and market as you do, it's a big plus because you're very involved personally as well as professionally.
Yeah, and you know, your hashtag better together could not be more appropriate for what I do, because I think you, like I, connect the dots, introduce people, and just, you know, spread the word about the good people that we like and know and can support each other. And really, as a PR facility, that's a big part of what I can do, to sort of say, okay, you know, we were meeting Nina Nolte earlier today to talk about Oscar Odeshi, who you've got on later today, about doing an event together. Because if you're doing separate things and you're all over the place, you don't have the power. So collaboration is key.
Yeah, it's wonderful. I'm glad you mentioned Nina Nolte, because she's one of my favorite artists. I've met her through the television program. For years, I've been interviewing her, watching how she progresses and grows, changes her styles. And for me, she was the natural choice when I wanted to launch the Marbella Love Mugs, because
yes,
you can't do everything on your own.
Yep.
And I thought, who has got, she's got the place, she's opened up a fabulous gallery, hosting other artists in the gallery as well, in the new Poligono in La Campana. And so it's really nice. I can't wait to launch this at the United Nationalities of Marbella event, because you say it's better together. Going to the event, this year it's all about our youth.
Yep.
You have a youngster that's growing up here.
I do.
And since we first met, I've been warning you, it's okay while he's at kindergarten and in the lower school, but you wait.
It's so true. Your event couldn't be better timed, Nicole, because he's going to be in high school in 2 years' time. And it does suddenly get much more real. What are they going to do? Where are they going to study? What are the job prospects for them? You know, where can they hang out in a safe space? So I think, you know, that the topic we've touched on in a few years now, but I think now's the time to really focus and bring people together who have not just the problems, but the solutions to those problems.
Exactly. I mean, regarding the teens, the youth hangout spaces, if we think how many sports clubs we have. When I was a kid growing up back in Surrey, I mean, I was obviously, it was privileged, but as a privileged child, all the sports clubs and golf clubs did activities for us.
Mm.
Our parents were very happy knowing that we were playing tennis in the morning, squash in the afternoon, having lunch at the club. Then we had teen discos. And I'm finding it very selfish, I think, of the local businesses that they're not doing anything to compensate or to cater to those kids.
Yeah. I think it's because they don't see the business opportunity, whereas I think that's very small-minded, because, you know, when you cater to a segment of a family, they will be grateful and loyal to you and likely come and support you, the parents, younger children, tell their friends, you know. And these teens, they might not be spending that much now, but in a few years' time, they're your future customers as well. So I think it's important to take the long view and to know that they can fill up time where you probably don't have anybody else coming. So those sort of early slots, those sort of funny times when you might be a bit dead, host something for them. Maybe it's a brunch, maybe it's a disco or coffee, you know, for special for teens. You know, open your mind to these opportunities, I would say, to businesses of any kind, and don't just think about how much are each one of those people going to be paying on the day.
Exactly. It's actually one of the cheapest forms of marketing that you can do, is investing in the teens. And this isn't me coming up with this idea, or Georgina. Let's just look at McDonald's. If you build it, they will come.
Yes.
And if you think in 2016 to 2021, children that were 15 years old are now 21.
Yeah.
It's a big difference. Mm. And if people had got involved before, those children would now be spending money.
Yes.
So I appeal to cinemas, hotels, especially sports clubs and places that have the areas to host them. And then another big subject, which I don't know if anything that they talk about this where Lucas goes to school, but this new worldwide pandemic of suicide, of teen suicide between 10 and 24-year-olds.
I couldn't believe that. When I saw that statistic, that really shocked me.
And that's pre-COVID.
Wow.
So just to think what the kids are going through.
Yeah.
And obviously, as our local community, both for Jacobo and for Richard in the sense, and the other children that don't come to our attention, and other people that apparently are many. I would say one in four people I've spoken to since we've been launching this campaign have lost someone to this.
It's unimaginable. I saw that this month there's Social Media Kindness Day to remember Caroline Flack, who took her life after being sort of bullied basically on social media. And I think that that's something that probably us older generations who haven't grown up with this, we're not necessarily aware of the impact that this is having and this hidden bullying that's happening. under our very noses and the kind of impact that's having. And, you know, I think especially with teens, they don't really want to share with their parents always. So to have a helpline, like I know that we were looking to fund with the event, is just so important to give someone a safe, anonymous space where they can reach out and share their concerns.
Exactly. And knowing where to call, because I know that when Benjamin George came onto the program, was talking about when he tried to take his life a year ago, and thankfully he reacted and he's with us now, and he's very, very happy, and incredibly to think that he could have wanted to do that and felt there was no way out. But when I asked him, why didn't you call someone? And he just didn't really know where to call. Yeah. And that's why I would like to make one number synonymous with despair, that it just comes to her mind at any given moment. Yeah. Because, as you say, it's easier to talk with a stranger frequently than with somebody that we know.
Yeah.
Also, something I've been thinking about is getting our local hospitals and clinics involved, because as they've got already the professional staff to deal with this, that maybe we could get them to do it in tandem, different days, like, you know, one hospital one day, one hospital the other day.
That's a good idea.
To get that international aspect going immediately. So a lot of ideas coming, but on the 18th of November, if anything we're talking about sounds synonymous, you can join us at the harbour for the United Nationalities of Marbella Summit, because I think this year the idea is to keep it small, think tank, and just to make a plan.
Yes, absolutely. And really we're looking for people who want to take action, you know, that don't just want to sort of moan. I don't want to be negative, but you know, it's good for us to have a moment, but I think now is the time for people that they might have the time, they might have the premises or the support structure in some way that they can put into place. We really need you. So please get in touch with us and we'd love you to join us on the event.
Yeah, I really do think it's going to be another great event. It's lovely to see actually all the things we do achieve every year just by networking, putting people together that just should know each other anyway. That is very difficult sometimes to get that. Another thing we've always trying to do is the grapevine, trying to get people to share other people's information and not just their own. Yes. Very difficult to achieve.
Yes, it is. And that, you know, that's something that I tell my social media clients. I just say, you know, don't be greedy when it comes to social media. You share the love. So tag other people in your posts. You know, share their post if it's relevant to your audience. They're likely to do it back to you. And that's how you start to grow your own supportive network. And I think that that's really something people need to kind of get into their mind. It is social, it is a network. And so rather than just think, pushing out my message, I need to be cultivating relationships and sharing things too.
Exactly, and that brings us to one of the last things that we'll be doing regarding our, specifically our youth, which is internships and career opportunities for our children, so that when they go to these amazing schools and universities that we offer, that they then can aspire to being trained up for a career.
So
if you have anything like that to offer, again, please do contact us.
I do hope now that restrictions are lifting and people are more relaxed about COVID that those opportunities will open up again, because I think, you know, the poor people that were graduating, you know, over the last year must have just been so stuck, because those kind of opportunities, nobody wanted to welcome strangers into the office. So I'm hoping that now businesses might say, okay, it's actually getting busier. I'm okay with having people in, we'll wear masks or whatever we need to do, but start opening up those ideas and thinking, what could I use the help with? Because I think if it's anything like my situation, people are getting busy and they might not want yet to take on staff, but perhaps have an intern. See how it goes. See how you could grow with some good help while training those people and giving them that first rung of the ladder that's so important.
It's so important. And even, say, for younger kids, an opportunity to go into different business just to see what it's about.
Yeah.
Because I remember being in Madrid and a friend of mine, her career is dressing people for television. I mean, there are so many jobs out there that we can't, or trying out new video games.
Yeah.
In the sense, the opportunities are endless. Georgina, I'm so delighted to count on you once again for the United Nationalities of Marbella.
So,
apart from everything else.
Always. It's so nice that we're back again and it's just going so fast, but I'm really grateful that we can do it, and we managed to do it last year and we're back again soon. And I really think that there's the structure is a great one, and I hope that we're going to get a lot done and a lot of people signing up to do good
to
for
do
the youth.
Good. Exactly. And just to mention, if you are a qualified psychologist, psychiatrist, Oh, international with your convalidado that is being equivalated, how would you say it, being convalidated, whatever the
yeah,
word is.
Yeah, I don't know. You're allowed to practice in
exactly,
Spain.
Allowed
well.
To practice in Spain. Yeah. We will be looking for volunteers, but I think all volunteers, we will be looking that they will be getting paid. Mm-hmm. Because if people offer to help others, I think it has to flow. Mm-hmm. And that they will know that they then will be getting money in. So mm-hmm. anyway, Georgina Shaw, thank you very much.
Thank you, Nicole.
Well done with everything you do.
Thanks.
And you guys don't go away, because we'll be back with Oscar Udeshi, very interesting young man who Georgina is helping promote on the coast in just a moment.
Judy likes to consider herself a clever young woman, which is why she thought very carefully before choosing her insurance company. Now that she needs it, she's jolly glad she chose Linear Director, as it looks as if she might have something better to do. Why don't you be clever, like Judy? Call Linear Director on 952 14 78 34 and see which policy is best for you.
Everyone that comes and wants to join our Zero Hero Association, they will have free non-alcoholic drinks at our venue at any time.
Hi guys, Ross here from Hogan Stand. Proud to be a member of the Zero Hero campaign. And we recommend everybody. Nobody drives drinking. Everybody who drives a car doesn't have any alcohol in their system. And we're proud to sponsor Zero Hero program.
Is happy to be Zero Hero partner.
How cool is that? GY.
Well, I'm proud to present Zero to Hero. Never drink and drive.
When I'm the designated driver, I think it's only fair that I get to choose a Zero Hero venue that rewards me with free soft drinks. My friends all get to choose and booze, and they feel safe going home with me. Make sure that you get your reward for being the designated driver. Why pay if you don't have to? Let it set you on
your way. No time to... Zero Hero, welcome here.
And they now turn their arrows.
Tearing us apart. Poison arrows shoot straight to your heart.
Welcome to Lemongrass, Doña Lola. Thank you very much.
Just believe it's worth your time. One. We are
Zero Hero, welcome to Portofino, Cabo Pino.
Hi guys, Casa Tua is proud to welcome the Zero Heroes. So come on in and enjoy free soft drinks for anyone who is the designated driver. Thank you, Nicole.
So here we are at Everest. Very cool.
Yeah.
Stickers going up.
Hey, my name is Govinda. I'm from Everest. Welcome to Zero Hero, to Everest Fusion, to enjoy your cocktails, drinks, and happy hour as well. And food, of course, is delicious. Thank you.
Change if we try. Just believe it.
So, welcome to Caesar Taperia. Perfecto.
Welcome back. A big thank you to Georgina Shaw of Shaw Marketing Services for that great little chat before the break. Joining me now, as Georgina mentioned, is Oscar Udeshi, one of Georgina's clients. And I'm really looking forward to chatting with Oscar because he is a tailor and a menswear designer. And boy, does he look sharp. Oscar, lovely to see you.
Thank you very much, Nicole. Thanks for having me.
A shame that it's so warm in here and you've taken off your beautiful waistcoat, because really the look is just lovely.
Yeah, but I'd look like a wet poodle then. It's a little bit warm here today.
It's pretty warm. The lights here are very bright. We were mentioning off air that the joy of seeing a man dressed in a jacket, looking elegant. I know it's very hot in Spain, but even so, having that opportunity to have this casual but formal look is quite unique. How did you get involved with fashion? Where did your passion start?
I grew up in Hong Kong, where we had a school uniform, so everyone looked the same. And then we had some children whose parents were a little bit more well-off and privileged, who would come in with cashmere jackets or blazers in chocolate brown, but silver cashmere. I'm like, eh. And I just couldn't care less. Until I was about 18, I went to university in London, and I went to one place dressed in jeans and a shirt, quite casually, and I couldn't really get served. I bought a suit because for interviews and other things, I went to the same store just to see, and lo and behold, wow, they were actually attentive. Wow, I actually got someone's attention.
It's funny, it's not a joke. The movie Pretty Woman, when she goes in and they won't serve her, it really is that way. Even if you travel, as a comment, if you're traveling, dress nicely, you will get much better service. But it really makes a difference.
People stereotype, people make first impressions. There's so much information, even more so now with social media and everything else, that you know you have a nanosecond. Do I like this person? Do I not? How rich are they? I don't see why that's relevant, but those are the questions that people subconsciously ask themselves. Is he wearing this watch? I had the same watch. Is he part of my tribe? What car does he wear? Where does his children go to school? Or whatever it is. Oh, he's a rich git, or I don't know if he can afford to come into this restaurant. People make preconceptions, and might as well make the most of it and exploit it.
So it wasn't necessarily a design passion. It was more of a passion to explore the power of the garment.
It was also easier to pick up women.
If you look nice.
Well, you have more likely to get someone's attention. And also it gives me or many wearers a certain sense of confidence, or you're dressing for an occasion.
So did you hire designers to create the look, or were you then inspired to actually get your hands involved and start creating?
Oh, I'm one of those arrogant people who thinks he knows everything better and then falls flat on his face. But I would prefer to do it that way and get a bloody nose, and at least I will hopefully have appreciated and learnt those lessons. And menswear is not that difficult. We have two arms, you know, two legs, most of us, not three. And menswear is very much historically based. And yes, there are some fashion whims here and there, whether suits are longer or shorter or wider lapels. But in essence, it hasn't really changed in 200 years. It's not like we've gone from a horse to a flying car.
So you haven't got men dressed in skirts, because that was a big thing a couple of years back with all the designers coming out with men in these lovely kilts and skirts. And
I have two kilts.
Okay.
I'm not Scottish. I have two kilts. I have friends of mine who actually own a mill that weaves, one of the last places that weaves all the 300 odd tartans. And so, and for an event, they're very comfortable. I can understand now why women wear them. A bit drafty, but
well, it depends. It could be nice and cool as well.
Yes.
Having grown up in Hong Kong, I remember my dad used to get suits made in Hong Kong while he was away on business. He'd have the suits ready to pick up and made to measure. Did that influence you, knowing that production possibilities from Hong Kong and from the markets? How did you then get into the business aspect?
I wanted two button collared shirts up here because I've got a longer neck. I wanted French cuffs and double cuffs for cufflinks with a two-button collar. Didn't exist. So I found somebody to make them. They were exactly what I wanted, and then as you buy more shirts or see what else is on the market and do your market research, oh, they're not very good. Well, they had this, but okay, so why do we have two buttons on a collar, or why are there buttons on a sleeve, or why is there a notch? Why is there a notch here as opposed to just one piece of fabric? And that historical aspect interested me. And then in Hong Kong, you don't pay very much, true, but there's only so many hours of man hours you can put into a garment. It's not the same thing as something from Savile Row, sake of argument, but it's a very different price point. I'm not saying one's better than the other, one's just more expensive, and if that's what you're in the market for, then fine. If you're going to wear a suit once a year, or you know, for a wedding or or funeral, God forbid, and you wear that suit occasionally, then you might be fine with something out of Thailand, if that's what your budget is and that's what's important to you. Same with cars. Some people buy some old banger, and some people will spend £1 million or euros on a car. That's got diamonds in the...
My dad got his own made in Savile Road as well, but I think it's that the joy is of being able to have something made just to fit you and choose your materials and it be done so quickly. But as I understand it, you're more of a Savile Row guy. This is your niche, and you're bringing that here to the Costa del Sol. How are you implementing this?
Well, I guess going back to what he says, probably the process of creation. Yes, I respect, or I've been trained in the English school, for want of a better expression, but I am my own little amateur history buff. Suits weren't always exactly the way they are now. So if you take a club blazer from a rowing team or something like that, they were very soft, they had no shoulder pads. It was like literally wearing an overshirt. And wearing a full three-piece Savile Row suit is a beautiful thing, slightly impractical for here. It's just like going hiking in high heels. Very sexy, but not particularly useful. And so down here, I don't really see anyone wear a suit, not even at the hotels, at the concierge anymore. But we do jeans, khakis, or chinos, the American word. We do unstructured jackets, so very soft, so something like a shirt, something you can throw in the washing machine, something much easier, but is, in my opinion, a step above of loungewear.
Still having that elegance and the dressing up without having to have all the paraphernalia that goes with it.
And without the weight and without the restriction. So you still look smart, but you're not over the top and you're not uncomfortable.
Your collections, are they available online, or do you make to measure? What's the system?
We sell online. We also sell to a few stores. And then the majority of our businesses are private clients, so we make for them. So, for example, you go in and buy your favorite pair of jeans in the shop. You come back, I'd like them again. Sorry, sold out, wrong size, wrong color, change the fit. My clients generally are cash rich, time poor, and it's just an extra faff. If you've got a restaurant that does your favorite meal, why do you keep needing to go to other places? So once we have your measurements, you're not gonna get taller, you're not gonna get shorter. With Corona, you could have got a little bit wider or narrower, but we'll know plus minus how many centimeters or inches. We make it again and again. Some clients I see every 5 years, and they go, do the last trousers fit? Yes, I'd like the same again. You sure don't want something different? No, no, I know what I want. Okay.
Another, it's a shame you're only doing menswear, right?
For my wife, I make jeans and khakis and trousers. I'm starting to, but for a man is a creature of comfort, he will buy 20 identical white shirts. A woman, every single white shirt is different. That's okay, that's a prerogative, but it's very hard to scale up that business, and you would have to charge an obscene fortune. Because a man goes, 20 shirts again, 20 shirts again. Do you remember that navy blue suit I bought last week from you? Yes, I'd like the same. So you'd like the same shape and fabric and gray? No, 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 no. I want exactly the same suit. Do you want me to put a number inside? No, I want it. Okay, exactly the same suit. Women, for good or for bad, don't dress like that.
Well, it's nice to know that it's interesting to see the concept behind how you are viewing the man's wardrobe. As I love what you're wearing. So someone to say, I like those trousers, I like that jacket. You just get the measurements and basically make it for them.
Well, we would meet them, fit them for it, make sure everything's fine, make sure it's also comfortable. It could look perfect, but if you're not comfortable, you're not going to wear it either. And then once we have those measurements, like I said, you're not going to really change that much in terms of your body shape. We have many clients who we see, in the Middle East or wherever it is in Scandinavia, and then we see them again 5 years later, we just make them again. We are very conscientious of how we make them, of the measurements we take and everything, so there are no surprises.
How long have you been here, Oscar?
Probably this year, Brexit was kind of the clincher. Do we still want to be in the UK? I lived in London for 25 years, my wife for 10 years. Is that the best place to raise our child? I've seen it, done it. I lived in Hong Kong until I was 18, went to London. It's time for a change. And there are definitely places with prettier beaches, but it's very hard to find a place that has everything that you have here. Ooh, south of France. Yeah, it's cold in winter. You have the fourth largest airport in the fifth largest city. Okay, there's no Opera House if you're really into that. But, pre-COVID, there were 25 flights a day to London. Now there may be 10.
We actually got opera coming on.
Beg your pardon.
In a week in Estepona. Clarice Williams is putting on an event to raise funds to help rebuild a Dana dog shelter. So she's going to be doing classical and opera singing. So although we don't have an opera house, fortunately we do have local talent that can make things happen. But yes, we are very well communicated to travel to England, Germany,
tennis tournaments, calling the gang, Julio Iglesias, okay, during COVID a little bit less, or whoever you want, you know, they come through Starlight, I believe it is.
So you're relatively new.
Relatively new, yes.
But you're enjoying it, regardless of the restrictions and the change, you're finding it easy to settle in?
In terms of restrictions, they're sensible. The case numbers were way too high, and it makes you appreciate what you have, and so it means put wearing a mask, then you just wear a mask.
And how did you get hold of our Georgina? How did you find out about her?
The wonders of the internet. And I met with a few, and that seems to be the only one that seemed to click, and having come from London as well, in the sense there was at least some common ground, and we just got on.
And she dresses nicely, and she's well educated, and it makes a big difference.
She does a good job.
She does a very good job. Oscar, delighted to meet you. I'm sure we'll be seeing a lot more of you. Welcome to Marbella. I hope you're very successful. And I hope you will contact Oscar if you would like him to make you some menswear garments. He'll be delighted. Don't go away, because we'll be back in just a moment.
Sometimes it's nice to just get lost in the moment without a care in the world.
However, if something does come up and you find you're actually lost, it's also nice to know that you can call Linear Director to come and find you. Call Linear Director on 952 14 78 34 to see how they can better your life too.
Alright guys, so I'm the designated driver tonight, so I'm going to choose the Zero Hero place. So all of my soft drinks are for free. And if you want to go somewhere else, just check out the Facebook, Instagram or the ZeroHero.es website for any of the bars, discotheques or restaurants on there. I'm happy to go anywhere you want to go, as long as it's Zero Hero.
Let the music get to your heart. Let it set you on your way. No time to hesitate.
Welcome to Lemongrass, Doña Lola. Thank you very much.
Tearing us apart. Poison arrows shoot straight to your heart. We can change it.
Zero Hero, welcome to Portofino, Cabo Pino.
As a tour is proud to welcome the Zero Heroes, so come on in and enjoy free soft drinks for anyone who is the designated driver. Thank you, Nicole.
Everyone that comes and wants to join our Zero Hero Association, they will have free non-alcoholic drinks at our venue at any time.
Hi guys, Lars here from Hogan Stand, proud to be a member of the Zero Hero campaign, and we recommend everybody. Nobody drives drinking, everybody who drives a car doesn't have any alcohol in their system, and we're proud to sponsor the Zero Hero program.
Tearing us apart, brothers, sisters, one beating heart.
GY is happy to be Zero Hero partner.
How cool is that? GY.
Glad okay. And proud to present Zero to Hero. Never drink and drive.
Magnosis is proud to be a Zero Hero partner.
John's car is still being repaired, so he's delighted that Judy has come to pick him up. However, after a very heavy business trip, he's less than enthusiastic when her car breaks down.
I ensure with Linea Directa.
She tells John.
So please do relax. I've got this.
And she had. The taxi was there in no time. Her car safely towed for repairs and a courtesy car readily available. Call Linea Directa on 952 14 78 34 to see how they can better your life too.
When I'm the designated driver, I think it's only fair that I get to choose a Zero Hero venue that rewards me with free soft drinks. My friends all get to choose and booze, and they feel safe going home with me. Make sure that you get your reward for being the designated driver. Why pay if you don't have to?
Hi guys, Ross here from Hoganstown. Proud to be a member of the Zero Hero campaign. And we recommend everybody. Nobody drives drinking. Everybody who drives a car doesn't have any alcohol in their system. And we're proud to sponsor Zero Hero program.
Set you on your way. No time to hesitate. We are all the same. So much trouble.
G1 is happy to be Zero Hero partner.
How cool is that? G1.
Thank you.
Cloud and I are proud to present Zero to Hero. Never drink and drive.
Yes, I mean, do you think this?
McNulty's is proud to be a Zero Hero partner.
Welcome here, and welcome to Lemongrass, Doña Lola. Thank you very much.
Zero Hero, welcome to Portofino, Cabo Pino.
Hi guys, Casa Tua is proud to welcome the Zero Heroes. So come on in and enjoy free soft drinks for anyone who is the designated driver. Thank you, Nicole.
So here we are at Everest. Very cold.
Yeah. Yep.
Stickers going up.
Hey, my name is Govinda. I'm from Everest. Welcome to Zero Hero, to Everest Fusion, to enjoy your cocktails, drinks, and happy hour as well. And food, of course, is delicious. Thank you.
Welcome to Sister Taperia. Perfecto.
Everyone that comes and wants to join our Zero Hero Association, they will have free non-alcoholic drinks at our venue at any time.
Welcome back. Joining me now is our CIT Marbella Guest of the Week. CIT Marbella is a business networking association, predominantly Spanish, which is very good because they really know who's who, what's what, and where's where, but also therefore very interesting for our international community. And a good opportunity for us, as they send a different member each week, to get to know some of the Spanish companies that are out there that do amazing things, as is the case with Area Design. And here to tell us more about it is Antonio. Nice to meet you, Antonio.
Nice to meet you.
I really do like having the CIT guest every week because there really are so many businesses.
Sure, sure.
And you do something completely different from the norm, which is 3D images of people's projects and designs. Did I get the right understanding of it?
That's it. Yeah, that's right. You know, it's kind of a new thing, right? And people really misunderstood sometimes what we do. We are basically a company, a virtual reality company. So we create all kind of services for real estate, property development. I think like anything, like any virtual service that they need, and also for architects, like for example, for architectural competitions. And we work with, I think, one of the best names in the sector nationally, not only in Marbella, but I would say like mostly in Marbella, but as well in Valencia, for example, in other coasts in Spain. And I would name, for example, Urbani International, Aidas Home, TME Group Inmobiliario.
So what is your service offer new, additional to a business? How does it help them? Why is it this new whatever? Why is it so cool?
Yes, we do the interior design, but what we, I would say, bring to the table is this, we use cutting edge technology. So we are always investigating in new technologies. For example, one of our services is we integrate everything in a website for the property developers. For example, all the images, 3D animations, which are like small clips, like videos, like promotional videos, for example, for TV and so on. You know, you have it all in the same platform in this website, and you can click on different buttons and you can change, for example, materials like the flooring or the color or of the anything, like the floors, like the walls. You know, because sometimes it's so difficult to visualize, right, to see the end result, and all this technology you are able to, like, one thing we did for Kerkus in Real de la Quinta, that you have like this video game with a gamepad, you're able to walk, and you know, you will see the house exactly as it will be.
So you get an understanding of the spatial distribution and everything.
Exactly. Like, to the smallest detail, to the size of the skirting, for example, like anything. You know, this brings like an additional value, right, to the real estate, because when you are buying one of these multi-million you know, euros properties, and it is a huge business, so you need to know properly what you're going to buy. You know, that's from the client side, and from the property developers, they want to have this amazing marketing materials, right? All these images for their villas and all this amazing interior design. So I would say we are not only, we started as a virtual reality company, but we like transition also to interior design, obviously, because we started to see our designs out there doing it for real. So we have this new department, so we are doing for real as well as
As you were talking, virtually. I'm thinking of the program The Property Brothers, and when they say they're gonna do over a house, and they will say, and it's gonna look like this. So it's that kind of thing, right? That you can
But you know, the feedback is so fast, because the clients, sometimes we work also for, you know, ordinary clients, people, right? So they want to see, like, on real time, how would it be like a change on the color of the sofa, or you know, and you can do that with this technology. That it's a good thing that we need to be all the time, you know, in this state-of-the-art technology, right?
And how did you get involved with this? Are you the technical brain, or are you the business mind, or are you both?
You got me. I am more of the technical part of the business. I take care of the infrastructure, because you know, on the backstage of these companies, we have like a huge network with all these softwares, and you know, it's not like the images, it's all this interior design, but on the other side, it's really important for the business to have this technological part, you know, fixed. So I'm taking charge of that. My sister Silvia, she's the founder, actually, the company. She started like 10 years ago. And she's like the person out there in Marbella. He's the well-known person here.
The promoter of the product.
She is.
How nice that you get to work together. That you complement each other, you do something that obviously you like. Did she realize that you had this technical ability and thought, let me get Oscar involved here?
A little bit, yes. I think she's an architect, So she started this company, and you know, as it grew, she realized that it has like an important technological part, and she needed like support on that, and it was like available. And also because of the relationships in here in Marbella, speaking English, right? How important it is for the community, right? For the Spanish community and the providers to speak good English, to be able to provide to all the international community and investors that are coming here to Marbella. And I would say this way we also get more involved, right, in which is the part of our city. Right?
And yeah, it's nice because you say the more people you know and the personal recommendations are important. Yeah. COVID has obviously been difficult for everybody, but possibly an advantage for your business with people realizing that they can still connect online and show people what's going on.
Exactly, exactly. Yeah, many clients realize of that, right, how important it is to have good images out there in their website, because the potential client could be in Norway or wherever, but he's looking on the website. So as I say, you need to catch the eye, right? You need to have this attention, and like the first stage on that is the images and 3D work, animations, and then the client will come to you and you will tell her or him like all the benefits of your project, but you need to get that attention, right? And so putting like emphasis, like putting real work on this part is key. And I think like all the real estate sector realize that.
Yeah. Lovely to see the passion that you have for what you do. Where are you from originally?
I'm from Malaga, born and raised.
So yeah. You are authentic Malagueños.
I am.
So few and far between. What an honor. Did you know as a child, we're doing this year for our United Nationals de Marbella Summit, we're talking a lot about our international youth and the lack of opportunities really for career options here and businesses opening to them. Did you know as a kid that you were, that the IT was your thing, coding? How did you get into this? Or did you have a dream as a child, or you just fallen into this? And thank you, Sylvia, for saving my life.
Yeah, I was really passionate about computers, I'd say. But also, you know, speaking about Marbella and the languages, it was me like living in Torremolinos. I was living in Torremolinos and seeing all these international people, and the difficult to make business at the time, but to just to talk to them. I realized how important was the languages, and I could do something in my city in Marbella with this, like a link in with companies. So this and computers and languages, I think it's a good mix.
It is definitely a good mix. You've mixed it together beautifully.
Thank you.
Is it very expensive, just for people listening? They have to. Is it a very big investment? Are we talking for big companies, or can medium and small companies also consider this type of option?
Right. To be honest, we specialize in the luxury real estate. So that's what we do. I would say for properties starting in 1 million from that point on, and we are doing in La Sagaleta like 14 million US properties. But I mean, I wouldn't say that is for...
So like, far, it's still a luxury product.
Yes.
Good
yes.
Thing we've got a lot of luxury clients in the coast. You're definitely in the right area. Oscar, I can't tell you how lovely, Antonio, how lovely it is to meet you. Thank you to CIT Marbella for sharing the members and what they do with us, because it's nice to know that what's out there. Look forward to seeing you again. And congratulations, and to Sylvia as well. What a wonderful idea.
Oh, thank you.
Encantada
de verdad. Thank you very much for having me.
Don't go away. We'll be back again in just a moment.
Judy and John are getting along famously. They have so much in common, which now includes both being too tipsy to drive home.
Oh, John, you can't drive home like that. Neither can I.
John looks worried, but not our Judy. She simply calls Linea Director for a free taxi and a tow truck to take her and her car home. Call Linea Director on 952-1478-34 to see how they can better your life too.
Alright guys, so I'm the designated driver tonight, so I'm going to choose the Zero Hero place. so all of my soft drinks are for free. And if you want to go somewhere else, just check out the Facebook, Instagram, or the zerohero.es website for any of the bars, discotheques, or restaurants on there. I'm happy to go anywhere you want to go, as long as it's Zero Hero.
Hi guys, Ross here from Hogan Stand. Proud to be a member of the Zero Hero campaign. And we recommend everybody. Nobody drives drinking. Everybody who drives a car doesn't have any alcohol in their system, and we're proud to sponsor Zero Hero program.
Set you on your way, no time to hesitate. We are all the same. So much trouble.
G-Wine is happy to be Zero Hero partner.
How cool is that? G-Wine.
Thank you.
Okay. I'm proud to present Zero to Hero. Never drink and drive.
Yes, I mean, do you think that's...
McNulty's is proud to be a Zero Hero partner.
Out of bounds, Zero Hero partners.
Here we are, sticker going on. Delighted to welcome everybody and to be part of the Zero Hero campaign. Delighted.
Zero Hero, welcome here.
At the Gaucho de Barons.
Welcome to Lemongrass, Doña Lola. Thank you very much.
Zero Hero, welcome to Portofino, Cabo Pino.
Hi guys, Casa Tua is proud to welcome the Zero Heroes. So come on in and enjoy free soft drinks for anyone who is the designated driver. Thank you, Nicole.
Everyone that comes and wants to join our Zero Hero Association, they will have free non-alcoholic drinks at our venue at any time.
So here we are at Everest. Very cold.
Yeah.
Stickers going up.
Hey, my name is Govinda. I'm from Everest. Welcome to Zero Hero, to Everest Fusion, to enjoy your cocktails, drinks, and happy hour as well. And food, of course, is delicious. Thank you.
Welcome to Sister Taperia. Perfecto.
I first met my next guest quite a few months ago. She's an opera singer, and it was just such a pleasure to have her on the program because she's joyousness personified and such a sweet person that it makes a lot of sense when she contacted me to say that she's doing a charity event to raise money for Adana, which is the animal shelter in Estepona, which unfortunately was almost burnt to the ground during the terrible fires in the Sierra Bermeja. Welcome back, Clarice.
Hi, what an introduction. That's so sweet of you. I'm quite moved, actually. And thank you for having me back again. I just want to give a slight correction. It's for the Ayuntamiento de Estepona's regeneration fund of the Sierra Bermeja.
Oh, for the Sierra,
yes.
Bermeja. So it's not specifically for the dog
it's
shelter.
It's not for Adana, no.
Okay, oh, that's good to know. So it's for the, actually, to just get the whole Sierra back again.
Yes. As people may well be aware, there was a tragedy in terms of the fire. I'm not going to get emotional about it. On the Sierra Bermeja for a couple of weeks in September. I was there, obviously I live in the Orcadario, which is center of town, and there was times I just couldn't look up. And I was quite dismayed, and there was ashes coming off the mountain. I mean, it's a disaster in a way that touches three bases, and that's environmental, it's plant life, indigenous plant life to the Sierra Bermeja, but also to Andalusia. It touches animal life. Obviously, Adana was raised to the ground, but also the refuge, which is a famous little landmark in the conservation area, completely gone. And then there's obviously the towns that were affected. I mean, Hubrique was evacuated. Yes. So the Ayuntamiento's regeneration fund is on a monumental scale, and the word is that it could be as much as 12 years to actually see some improvement. So on one of the Facebook groups, when people were talking about how can we help, and there was GoFundMe and different things, and I thought, well, how can I help? And then I thought, okay, I'd love to do a fundraiser, a concert, because music is extremely healing. And it doesn't matter what genre of music it is, it touches the heart. And Estepona has been my home for 6 years. I love it dearly. It's looked after me, and it was my chance to look after it. So I approached the council. And I didn't know about the Regeneration Fund, actually. I hadn't heard about it, which is a terrible thing to say, because
no,
I mean,
I didn't know. And I just said, I thought you were doing this for the Sierra Bermeja, for Adana.
Absolutely.
But that's why we come on the show, and that's why we talk to each other.
Share information.
Exactly. We need to share information. It is hard to let everybody know what's going on.
Yes. Well, it was them that told me, because I said, look, could I... you know, could you gift us a theatre? Because obviously with these sorts of things, it's always going to be your infrastructure. And I basically brainchild it. I gave birth to the idea. I've organised it. I've got all the promotional material with the help of the council. And they said, look, we have a regeneration fund. We'll give you a theatre, Padre Manuel, which is in the Delegación del Cultura. It's a 200-seat theatre, €15 a ticket. We want to sell out. 100% money is going all to the foundation, all to the fund. The performers, El Rebelaje, is a fantastic... they tour throughout Spain. They're a guitar ensemble, but they also have other musicians and singers. David Geary, retired opera singer. Do opera singers ever retire? I don't know. Man of a certain age, I'd say 88. No, don't. I've got to stop it whenever I get around you, Nicole. I always start to get naughty. I don't think. But he's also performing. We have the Coro Magna Mysterium. They are a local Estepona classical choir with a lot of Spanish flavour, a lot of Spanish cultural influences. But they perform in festivals in Europe. And before the pandemic, 2019, they were at a vocal symposium in Prague. So they also tour Europe-wide, but they're also locals. I've got a wonderful local classical pianist. She's more contemporary classical, Katie Rowlands. She's at a local school in Sotto Grande, teaching, I think, music there. Obviously myself, I will be singing as well.
Opera singer.
I'll be singing some arias from Bizet's Carmen, which I performed in Cadiz in May, and I'll also be singing a little aria from the Sor Angelica. I think we kind of touched on it on my whistle stop whirlwind talk with you in August, and that's happening end of the month in November, so we're actually doing that. So I'll be doing a little showcase of that opera. And then there's also Kat Waddell, very interesting lady I met on my travels in Cadiz, from New York, teaching at a music school in Madrid, fantastic flautist, and she's coming down as well for the night. Everyone is performing for free. We have sponsors, some fantastic local sponsors. I'm looking for more if anyone wants to give donations. All the money is totally going to the Regeneration Fund on the night.
Absolutely fabulous. And I am so impressed of how you've listed off all the people performing with their history, where they're from, what they're doing. Very impressive lineup.
Thank you. I can't say enough. I'm so proud of everybody's involvement. The spirit of the community has been immense. As I said, I'm not going to cry, but because it's going to be 10 years mass, more mass, I said mass, 10 years mass, 10 years more, you know, I would do this every year, and I'm exhausted already. That's the weird thing, because normally when I sing, I don't have this hat. So I'm not chef, cook, and bottle washer. But it's been an amazing experience, and I'd happily do it again.
Well, I think it's wonderful to see how an individual obviously a lot of effort, a lot of work, a lot of stress. But when you do it with the passion that you're doing to give back, undeniably it's going to be successful. I'm really looking forward to the evening. I'm definitely going.
So are you going to come?
Definitely. Oh, fantastic. So it's 15 euros. €15. What's the date?
It's Friday 12th. No, that's right. I nearly had a memory blank after I rattled off the artist and sponsorship. It's the 12th of November, 8 o'clock. The doors will be open at 7. We are doing like a reserve list because I'm thinking there's going to be a very much a last minute rush. So if you want to be on the reserve list, that means your seat is secure. And then at 7 o'clock, you can view the wonderful raffles. I mean, I've got raffles that are like €100. I mean, there's Monomoon, which is a wonderful designer boutique in Estepona, and she's giving away hand-designed fan and a beautiful panuelo, which is gorgeous. So there's some really, really great sponsorship. My Avon, I'm going to sponsor with some moisturizers as well.
So it's going to be, you can see the type of evening you're going to have. Awesome entertainment, an atmosphere, an ambience of joy, of giving back, of sharing, of being better together. Clara's, thank you so much.
Thank
Lovely
you.
To see you again. And thank you for joining us once again. Please do support my guests by liking and sharing the program on your social media and obviously contacting them if you want to take part in anything they're doing. Please watch recordings of the show from either the RTV Marbella website, which is rtvmarbella.tv. For my program, it's then/Marbella-now. Or you can go to my website, nicoleking.es, for links to the program. Also to the Zero Hero website, with full listing of venues offering free soft drinks to designated drivers. And also a link to my Marbella Moments column in the Euro Weekly News. Should be enough for you to get on with. Oh, no! Don't forget to go to our u-n-m.org website. Compilation of information on our United Nationalities of Marbella Summits. That's it for the moment. Take care of yourselves, be nice to each other, and join us again next week for more of what's going on in Marbella Now. Thank you. We are all the same. So much trouble tearing us apart.